and we need you every hour, every moment, every day. And our desire is to worship you alone. So God, we ask that you would take our preoccupations and our desires that do not help us to worship you. Help us to set all those things aside so that we can indeed worship you with pure and right hearts. God, it is good to worship you together and to give thanks to you in this season of Epiphany, when your light is still shining and reaching down into our souls and into all the world, God, and changing everything. God, sometimes we want everything to stay the same. We want to hold on to what we believe and what we know and what is familiar and what we like and the way it is and the way it was and the way it used to be. And God, we are surprised. We're taken aback when Jesus passes by and he says, change now. Change now. Change now. Change now. God, this kingdom of change is shocking. The way life changes is surprising. So God, help us. We need your help. We cannot do this. We cannot do anything without your Holy Spirit and your help. So we pray for your Holy Spirit, even as we pray for this world that needs change, that needs the change you come proclaiming, the change in us, the change in circumstances, the change in attitude, change in the way we talk, change in the way we act. God, help us to be the change that is needed in this world so there will be more wholeness, more unity, more peace. The things that we desperately need, God. Fill us with joy. We continue to worship you. Open our ears and open our hearts and open our minds. Help us, God. Change us. We dare to say, change us. For your kingdom is a kingdom of change. We pray in the name of Jesus, who teaches us to pray together by saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Today's scripture comes from 1 Corinthians 7, verse 29 through 31. I mean, brothers and sisters, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing, and those who buy as though they had no possessions, and those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it. For the present form of this world is passing away.
Invite the children to come forward at this time. Get all up. Big kids, little kids, money kids, serious kids. Thank you. guys, gals. Good. Awake. Awake. Kind of a dreary, rainy day. You kind of don't want to get out of bed. You kind of sleep. So I decided that I was going to do some work here. So I'm all set up. I have. Let's get set up here. Not quite set up, I guess, like I thought. I have my computer here, at least part of it. I have my church directory. Every one of your names are in here. So in case I need to get a hold of you, I have that. And my Bible, that often comes in handy, right? So I am all ready to work. I'm doing my work. I'm enjoying this. And all of a sudden, Jesus comes to my office. And he says, get up and follow me. So I'm gonna leave all this. I'm going to leave this over here. I've got to put my Bible down. I've got to put this down. And excuse me if you'll just stay right here. I'm going to go follow Jesus, okay? I'll be back sometime. Right? See ya. Okay. Well, that was fun and interesting. You know, you trust me so much, don't you? You knew I'd come back, didn't you? Well, there's a story, several stories in the Bible about Jesus calling people. Today's story is about how Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee, and there were some fishermen doing their work. They were mending their nets because that was their work. That was their job. And so they were doing their job, and Jesus came along and he said, hey, follow me. You know what they did? What they did? They followed him, right? That's exactly right. They followed him. They got up. They left their father. They left their fishing nets in the boat. And they got right up and they followed Jesus. Now, I wonder a little bit about this. This is kind of crazy, isn't it? I mean, it's kind of a crazy thought. I'm going along doing my job here, trying to do my very best. And I've got all my tools and everything. And Jesus comes along and he says, hey, get up, follow me. That's kind of weird, isn't it? You know, I was doing what I was doing. And those fishermen were doing what they were doing. They were doing their job. It makes me wonder a little bit. I wonder how they felt about it. Anybody have any idea how they felt when Jesus said, follow me, and they got up? Do you think they were scared a little bit? Yeah. Do you think they were maybe excited? Yeah, I think they might have been scared and excited at the same time. I wonder what they were thinking. Do you think they were trying to figure out where they were going to go and what Jesus was going to ask them to do? Yeah. It had to be crazy. That's crazy. But they did it. Jesus came along. He said, get up and follow me. And they followed. And sometimes when we're busy doing what we do, I'm going to tell you, Jesus comes along. You might hear his voice inside your heart or see some opportunity, some chance to do good or something you know that he wants you to do. And it might even sometime in your life be something really big. And he says, get up and leave what you're doing and drop it and stop it and come and follow me instead. So I want you to be ready, okay? I want you to be listening. Right? You look excited like this is going to be fun. Jesus is going to come along. And you're all smiling about this. I knew you would be because you guys are always ready. And I want you to always be ready for Jesus to come and say, follow me. What are you going to do? You're going to drop it all, and you're going to follow, right? All right. Will you pray after me? Thank you, God, for this Sunday, and for your love, and for Jesus, who says, follow me. When he says, follow me to us, help us to be ready to follow. To get up, to drop everything, You guys are so great. Thank you. I have to get up. That's the hard part. Change us, we pray.